Hello everyone, I'm Ankit Bhavna, a partner engineer working for CameraKit at Snap. Today we are going to walk you through how to develop a lens for the CameraKit and process of adding it to your CameraKit app. Currently, CameraKit is in closed beta, but we are continuously growing our developer community. If you are interested, then join us and head over to kit.snapchat.com/CameraKit and request access. We can't wait to see what you will create. For this demo, we are going to be using CameraKit version 1.6 and Lens Studio version 4.0. It is important to ensure that the Lens Studio version you are using is compatible with the version of the CameraKit. To ensure that, go to the documentation of the CameraKit Getting Started guide and check out this table. After double checking, looks like we are good to go. So I'll pass this over to Chris to walk you through a process of creating a lens.
Thanks, Ankit. My name is Chris, and I'm a partner engineer here at Snap focused on lens creation for CameraKit. Let's open up Lens Studio to a lens I have been working on, which is just about completed. Here we have our lens, which features face stretching, some other face attachments, as well as some 3D assets. I've also included some text, which says LensFest 2021. For the most part, I've developed this lens just as I would for publishing on Snapchat, but have taken extra precautions to ensure it will look as intended in our CameraKit application. Since the CameraKit application can have different UI and render regions from Snapchat, it is important to ensure that UI elements are pinned to edges of the screen, as I have done here for this LensFest text. I have pinned it to the left, bottom, and right edge of the screen. In many cases, we will also want to do this relative to the safe render areas, which can be controlled and set within your CameraKit application. I have done this here in the screen region component, setting it to safe render. Now that we have done this, we will verify the project info. Here we have our lens name, new lens, and our icon already set. These will show in the default carousel in your CameraKit application. For CameraKit, we will handle the additional settings, such as the lenses made for tags, using vendor data associated with each lens and group. Now we will click publish and wait for our lens to upload. And keep waiting. When we're submitting a lens, we have the option to submit it as either a business lens or community. Let's select community for now. Everything looks good to go, but we will also want to verify the visibility setting that we want to use for this lens. By default, it'll be set to public, which allows it to be searched by all Snapchat users. If we want this to only show in our CameraKit application, we will set this to hidden. In this case, we'll keep it as public and click submit lens. And now we wait. And there we go. Our lens is now available in My Lenses, and we can add it to our group to be used within CameraKit. In the CameraKit portal, we will click Add New Lens Group to create a new lens group. Here we can set the name of the lens group and the lenses that we want to use in that group. Here are all the lenses currently available to me in my portal. I'll add these two and set the group name to Demo Group. After doing this, I realize I also want to add the new lens to this as well. I'll click on the new lens and click Add Lenses. Now I have all the lenses I want available in my group. As mentioned before, if we click into the lens that we just created, we can see some areas here for vendor data. Vendor data allows us to add additional data along with the lens when it gets downloaded. For this, we can do things such as making it so we associate this only with the front camera, which we can handle later in our CameraKit application. For this, I'll set the attribute name to front and the attribute value to true. I've done this up top here, which applies this vendor data to this lens across all groups. If this lens was also available in different groups, I could set it down below and have it only be relative to each group. I'm happy with how this looks now, so I'll click Save Changes and go back to my group. The only other thing to note here is that there's the priority setting here on the right. The priority will control the ordering within the carousel in your CameraKit application. Here, I will set Oh, I don't want to do that. Here I will set, I'll change the priority so that the new lens will be the first one in the carousel. I'll click Save Changes. And with that, our group is ready to go. Now the next step will be to copy this ID for later use in our camera kit application. I'll pass this back over to Ankit, who will handle those next steps.
Thank you, Chris, for creating this wonderful lens. Now let's see how easy it is to have this lens as part of your app. For this, head to kit.snapchat.com. You will be presented with two options, either create a new project or select an existing one. For this demo, we're going to use one of the existing ones. Under the versions, select initial version, scroll down, and toggle camera kit to on. Next, go under the global setup section. Make a note of the SnapKit app ID. We're going to need this for authentication purpose later on. Next, add your app ID, com.snap.camerakitdemo, and select platform as Android. Now the fun part, adding these lenses to your app. We will cover only the Android app in this demo. iOS app is quite similar as well. Download and open the Camera Kit sample app for the quick reference to everything that we're going to talk about today. Now open your app in Android Studio and add the dependencies for Camera Kit SDK. For the simplest implementation, add dependency for support-camera-activity. This will let you launch the camera activity which uses the carousel that we created for you to use the configuration you pass to it. If you want more customizations, then make sure to check out the full sample app. Next, in the manifest file, add the required permissions for camera, internet, microphone, and storage. Camera activity will take care of the permission prompts for you so that you don't have to worry about them yourself. Next, add metadata tag under the application for com.snap.camerakit.app.id and value as SnapKit app ID from the CameraKit portal. Now you're all set to use the creative lenses that you have created. In your activity, register for the activity result to handle pictures or videos that user takes, and use that to launch camera activity with the configuration options you want. Make sure to provide the lens group IDs from the CameraKit portal. Some of the configuration options include launching camera activity with only one lens, with or without icon, or with all the lenses in the carousel with a particular one selected, or none of them selected. Download all the lenses when your activity is launched, etc. You can also check for the vendor data which Chris set earlier for the front camera from the lenses component class and launch the lens with default as front camera or the back camera. Make sure to check the API documentation for a full set of details. Finally, let's run the application with the lens Chris created for us. Nice work, Chris. We can't wait to see what you guys create using CameraKit.